everyone, welcome back to another episode of TidBits. I'm your host, Marlyonama, and here I'm going to look into the exploitation called franchise milking.
Now, franchise milking is not anything new. It's been around since there's been TV shows, movies, and even video games of popular brands. I mean, ever since the 1980s, when direct marketing to kids became legal, corporate bigwigs in the entertainment industry have gone on a gold rush over milking existing properties rather than creating new ones altogether. And this has even gone on to big toy sellers like Mattel and even big cable networks like Nickelodeon and their Rugrats movies, which is why 2D animation's now dead in theaters. And yes, I will get to that in a second, but the crux of the issue has to extend on into the video gaming industry, particularly recently, since we've now moved on to mobile devices and streaming services. And nowadays, it has become a lot worse. Worse than Madden and NFL continue to rehash the same game every year, especially Call of Duty. Like, for example, would be the Dynasty Warriors games, where we get the exact same Three Kingdoms time period battles over and over and over again with only slight variation, only to have an attempted reboot just mess up the entire franchise and then make up for it with awful microtransaction mobile games. Because of Dynasty Warriors 9 failure last year, they are now promoting Dynasty Warriors 8, and I don't know, and I'm pretty sure that they'll downright retire the whole franchise. Oh, and let's not forget about Fallout, and under the director and stewardship of Todd Howard, including Fallout Shelter and Fallout 76. Yeah, the dreaded Fallout 76 that's completely broken. He spent the entire effort on an MMO spinoff that barely works.
4 times the size of Fallout 4.
And he's been laughing all his way to the bank. That's sleazy. And it's gotten so bad that the developers and publishers have even tried to justify downplaying their own mainline product that's either disappointing or below the people's standards. Like, for example, Square Enix. They have basically done that with the Final Fantasy brand with their trash like Final Fantasy All the Bravest and Theatrhythm. But the biggest slap in the face of all is the disappointment of Kingdom Hearts 3. Now, this is not to say Kingdom Hearts 3 is a bad game. It's a disappointing one because a lot of the content that could have been in there have been cut. All to basically tailor to those random original characters that only appeared in the spin-offs that no one gives a shit about. This could also explain why they cut all the beloved Final Fantasy cameos, even though said game was supposed to be a Disney Final Fantasy crossover from the beginning. It's like taking out all the violence in Mortal Kombat and saying, "Parents complained! There's no need for violence!" Or saying, "Kingdom Hearts is a big franchise altogether, so it doesn't need the Final Fantasy brand."
Bullshit.
Then if you're saying that, then we don't need the Disney characters helping them out either. You're basically stepping away from what made the franchise as a whole. All because you could focus on Mary Sue's that were already supposed to be dead this point in the game to begin with. So you don't really need them to wrap up the whole Xehanort saga, which I'm not going to go into because I don't want to go into spoilers at this point. But you get what I'm saying. No one gives a flying fuck about Dissidia NT. No one certainly gives a flying fuck about 228 over 2 days or the Chi Unchained bullcrap. I mean, you're making the simple game line of what made the original two great and turning into a complete clusterfuck. Maybe you could just dismiss a few of them as canon instead of retconning the whole thing. Please make up for this in DLC. Please make up for the missing content that should have been Kingdom Hearts 3 but isn't, and I may forgive you. But, because other than that, franchise milking is downright bullshit. It also degrades and undermines the existing brand as we know it. Makes it even duller and more disappointing.
Now, in all due respect, it's not always a bad thing, but it has gone out of control to where we produce half-assed products that do not benefit neither the customer nor the company in the long run. Just a quick fix. Yes, I cannot believe I'm digging my hands in all this liquid gold. Stupid idiots. I can pissing people off, it's cheapening your brand to the point where you're forced to retire it in exchange for a new IP. Now, this can be costly to a business, and many other people can lose their jobs over this, through layoffs, termination of the right people, and so on. As for the consumer like I, you should watch over you got you thieves. Otherwise, whoever CEO is making that decision, you should be fired and find another job. Again, this is Marlyonama, signing off.